Welcome to the Automation Zone, a video series brought to you by Miracle's RPA Center of Excellence.
Hi, and welcome to the Automation Zone video series. I'm Monica Chirukuri from Miracle's Innovation Labs. Today, we will be talking about how we can automate the SAP accounts payable process with UiPath. Here is our agenda for today. We will see how process automation can help the enterprises. We're going to see what is meant by cognitive process automation, what is UiPath, and what are the capabilities that it can offer, how we can implement email and SAP GUI automation, what are the benefits of AP process automation. We're also going to explore the flow of AP process automation as well, followed by a live demo. So process automation is used for optimizing business processes to achieve greater operational efficiency. So enterprises are now turning to process automation to automate the repetitive and role-based activities in their enterprises. So it provides a way better approach of doing things easily and very smoothly. It provides accuracy, reduced costs, thereby strengthening the relationships between the employee and customers. Technologies like cognitive automation are setting new trends and goals in the market today. So by adopting cognitive automation, human tasks can be replicated at rapid speed. So RPA automates repetitive tasks and optimized processes, whereas the conversational chatbots can understand our natural language and give responses according to that. So it will be just like talking to your friend or a person. So some of the examples that help us in creating the RPAs are Automation Anywhere, UiPath, Pega, Blue Prism. So some of the frameworks that help us in building conversational chatbots are message.ai, vid.ai, Amazon Alexa, IBM Watson Conversation Service, Microsoft Lewis, etc. UiPath provides mainly three functionalities, which are UiPath Studio, Orchestrator, and Robots. So UiPath Studio is for users, like it helps users in modeling business processes. Users with absolutely no coding skills can design robotic processes in a visual and very interactive interface. So UiPath Orchestrator is a browser-based server application through which we can deploy and manage thousands of robots. Here we can schedule the robots and even put them in queues to run one process after the another. UiPath robots are execution agents, so they can run in two ways actually, attended and unattended. So attended is for like if there's an activity that needs human intervention, more like front office tasks, we use attended automation. And unattended automation is for like if there is an activity that does not need any human intervention, like back office tasks. So there we will use unattended automation. UiPath has the ability to connect to databases. So in our use case here, what we're going to see is the account payable process automation. First, we need to go with the email automation. Here, we can fetch the credentials from database and use them to log into the mail server. And then in the mail, we'll only fetch the mails which are in unread state. So that will be taken into consideration. And the attachments, the invoice will be in PDF format and they will be attached to the email. So they need to be downloaded to our local folder. So each downloaded invoice is then scraped to extract the text out of it, and then the extracted data will be sorted into a single it will be in a single variable, and then it will be categorized into fields. SAP GUI has to be logged in first. So after we're done with the email automation, then comes the SAP part. So here we need to log in with the credentials that we get from the database. And then in order to enter the invoice details into SAP, we will have to execute one command, that is FB60 command, which will provide a prompt for us to enter all the details of an invoice like vendor name, invoice data, date, product name, price, all of the information that an invoice consists of. Once we're done with inserting all these required fields in SAP, we will need to save that information. So for every invoice that has been downloaded, the same process of scraping the data and entering into it, SAP will be repeated. Since the RPA is going to record all the processed and non-processed invoices, so there won't be any situation called there will be any lost invoices or the invoice has to be paid twice or nothing like that. So it only takes seconds to execute the RPA, which saves organization a lot of more time. So the accounts payable process is also a back office task, and then unattended robot is used for it, resulting in reduced human intervention. So as the invoices are entered into SAP in a timely manner, there won't be any late payments. And the whole process, automation process is very easy to use, and it produces very accurate results. So this improves the relationship between the suppliers and as well as the customers. So this is the flow of the AP process automation. So once the process, like when we start the RPA, it will fetch the credentials from the database and logs in into our email server, whether it's Gmail or Outlook or anything. It will log in into it, and it will read only the unread emails from a particular sender. We need to configure it to read only the emails that are coming from a particular sender. And if they have any attachments, they're going to be downloaded to a local folder. And once that is done, the RPA will log into SAP GUI with the credentials that it fetches from the database. So once that is done, what it will do is it will go to the downloaded invoice folder, and it will start fetching one invoice after the other. So like if it goes and sees in the folder if an invoice exists, what it does is it will go to this process here, and it will read all the text out of that invoice. Since the invoice will be in a PDF format, it will read all the text, and it will be stored into a single string variable. So what we have to do next is we have to categorize that string variable into different fields, like what is the vendor name, product name, stuff like that. So once that is done, and once the categorization is all done, we need to see if the data is valid or not. So for that, we need to check some conditions like vendor should already be configured in master data configuration, and product name should be configured as a GL account in SAP. And also the tax code should also be valid, and invoice should also be not present already in SAP. So then only the data can be entered into SAP. So if all those checks passes, the data will be entered into SAP. On successful insertion into the SAP, that invoice will be moved to processed invoice folder. So like if any of the checks fail, that invoice will be sent to the failed invoices folder. And then the process will be repeated. So it again goes back to the invoices downloaded invoice folder, and it will fetch the invoice. If it exists, it will fetch that invoice, and the whole process will be repeated again until the end of the last invoice. So when there are no invoices to process, what it will happen is it will close the SAP GUI, and the process will be stopped there. Let's see all this in action. First, I'll show you the format of the invoice that we're going to use today. So in this invoice, it will have all the vendor and product information along with the invoice date and invoice number. So this invoice is from Miracle Software Systems vendor, which is already configured as a vendor in SAP. So let's see the second invoice. This invoice has the lab team as a vendor. So this vendor is not configured in SAP. So when the RPA comes across with this invoice, it shouldn't enter the details into SAP since the vendor is not configured. And it should toss this invoice into a failed invoices folder. So these invoices are already mailed as attachments to my Gmail account. If you already have UiPath Orchestrator, you can run the RPA directly from there. Or if you have UiPath Studio, you can trigger the RPA from command prompt. So once the UiPath RPA has been started, you can close this window so that the RPA has already downloaded the invoices. So it's going with the SAP login now. So it will take one invoice after the other. So we have written a small Java code in between, which will divide all those invoice details into particular fields, which is nothing but one and pattern matching. So here it will divide that data into different fields like invoice date and product name and all. Once that is done, that particular information will be entered into SAP. So the RPA will search for the vendor name, whether it's present in SAP or not. It will enter all the invoice date and number. So it will also search for the product name, which is nothing but the GL account in SAP. It will also select the appropriate tax code. Once all the information has been entered, it will be submitted into SAP. Then the process of the second invoice will start. So the same process will be repeated for the rest of the invoices as well. Here for the second invoice, the lab stream is not configured, so we can see at the left corner like no values for this selection. So the RPA will stop this process here and it will go on with the third invoice. It will also move that particular invoice into fail invoices folder as well. You can see the process of the third invoice has been started. So whether there are like 100 invoices or 1,000, the same process will be repeated for all of those invoices. So if those invoice data is been valid, those will be entered into SAP and then they'll be moved to processed invoice folder. If the data is invalid, like any of it has any error or anything, so we have written an error handling in the RPA so that it will push all those into the fail invoices folder. So once all the invoices are done, the SAP will also be get closed. So you can see that the execution has been ended and the invoices from the download invoice also disappear because all the valid will be going to the processed invoice folder 1 and 3. And there was an error while inserting the second invoice because the vendor is not configured, so it's been moved to failed invoices folder.
Thank you for watching The Automation Zone, a video series brought to you by Miracles RPA Command Center. For more about automation, please visit miraclesoft.com/RPA.